to delete the other one that I just did because the volume was not up and now is up. And that made my face look bright. It is August 27th, 2019, and it is 11:30 in the evening. Just got home. Earlier we had Cella Latou's, our sister choir, or not our sister choir. I'm gonna try really hard not to talk like I'm dead tired. Our sister from Divine Heritage Choir. Today was her birthday, and so she was buried on her birthday. And it was nice because we got to see a lot of people last night from the choir and their families, and then today. And so I wanted to talk about what it means to overcome the feelings of feeling tired and fatigue, because whether or not you've had a productive day or you've had a crappy day. And today was definitely a productive, great day with spending with my choir family. And then, hi Mackie, spending with my choir family. And then with my sisters, Tyree and Caroline. And you guys will hear a lot of their names come up as we continue to do lives. And so we were talking about, like, what do we get from the funeral? Like, what are our aspirations? What are we going to change in our life? And I actually, it's a bittersweet thing when attending funerals, because with Pacific Islanders, it's like a whole event. Like, it's already an event in normal life, like with other cultures and like just Americans. Everybody has their thing. But with Pacific Islanders, that is like, if the person passed away today, then you had to give at least a week for all the family from wherever. It normally give them a week to get to you, and within that week, every day somebody's bringing either food or cultural gifts or money, just to help lift the family that is mourning. And then you have beautiful music. If the family is open, music is like all day long from break of dawn to the sunset and beyond. And so with Cella, we were able to go ahead and we were able to sing a few songs last night. I think we sang like 5 songs, but then it's not just our choir, it's like their family choir, and then maybe if they're members of the church, it's their war choir. So it was, we got there at 5:30 p.m. and didn't leave until 11:30, and they were still going. And then today we got to the chapel around 7 a.m. and then it didn't end. We left early, right as her brother bore his testimony in the bishopric meeting. And I believe everybody like finished the burial and everything by 3. So that's like 7:30 a.m. to 3. And then if you're hanging out after, because the eating is just a lot. It's a lot, but it's awesome because you're reunited. And so the reason I wanted to talk about fatigue and being tired is because I am tired, but it's a good tired. But I feel like when we're going through our days, it's hard to sometimes even admit that we're tired, because there's things in our life. If you're in school, if you're in work, you're trying to get done, or if you're a stay-at-home parent, mom or dad, you're trying to get things done for your family and for yourselves. And sometimes what happens is that you overload yourself with all these things that may be productive, but I have had to learn the hard way. If you don't take care of yourself physically, mentally, emotionally, you will not be effective in whatever you're trying to get done. And I also bring that up because last night's live, when I was talking to you guys, is that
I almost like freaking passed out and I didn't know if I was having a stroke or what, because never have I ever, if we were playing that game, never have I ever. And so I was really mindful of that today. And that was one of the reasons why I left. I left early with my sister Terry, because as soon as we got home last night about midnight, I did not sleep until like 4:30, because I was just watching old videos of Sela singing, and then going through pictures of our choir trips, and just listening to everybody's not listening, actually reading everybody's comments on Facebook, because you know, if people are night owls like me, they'll stay up. And I really was trying to push myself to go to sleep around, I think it was 2:30, 3 o'clock in the morning, but I couldn't, because I guess my mind was just preoccupied because I knew we were gonna sing again. And so if you're that type of person that's a workaholic or a schoolaholic, or just you have sleep apnea, oh frick, I said that wrong. Anyways, sleeping, you know, problems. I would suggest, like, one thing, Mel Robbins, she's one of my favorite, like, influencers. She says, like, just turn off your phone. Like, if somebody really needs to get a hold of you, they will find a way, but turn off your phone, have your phone in another room, like, mainly like in your living room or your bathroom. I think we're so addicted, at least I know I am. We're so addicted with our phones, and we have to, like, it's almost like another limb that we feel like if we don't have our phones every time near us or around us, we're gonna lose our minds. But I know for myself, like, phones suck, because even when you're sleeping, you're like consciously or subconsciously just waiting for your phone to go off, because we're just addicted. We're like zombies walking around with our, we're chained, we're pretty much chained to our phones. So I think that would be, like, if you're trying to improve your state of rest and hi Pono, miss you brother, state of rest, and try to up your energy, just put your phone, turn it off, put it in another room. And then they've even suggested, his name is Dean, I want to say Garbazi, and he's suggested that don't even turn your phone on when you wake up first thing in the morning. If you're religious or spiritual, say your prayers, meditate, exercise, have, excuse me, exercise, have your daily routine be something that helps you feed your mind without jumping online and on social media sites immediately. And so these are just a few things I try when I'm not getting good sleep. I try to do things that I try to bring into my, like, system to have peace of mind, is to not dwell on the things that happened the day before. And this part takes forever, especially when you're not consistent. And so things that I try not to take into the next day, or any arguments that I've had with people, any miscommunications, any disagreements, I just try really hard not to take that into the next day. Now that is actually something that's easier to do with my besties and, like, my siblings when I'm not super mad at them. It's easier for me to be patient, empathetic, to them, to not carry on the argument or whatever. But with my mom, it's not so easy. So it's something, it's a muscle that I, since I swear, like, I was in the womb, was something that I struggled with. Probably was kicking her like 9 days, because eventually I was gonna come out and be what I've become. And so trying to work on that, strengthening that muscle by following the examples of my siblings on respecting her more and not being such a hard head. Another thing that I probably want to touch on that was something that came to mind when speaking to my sisters, Tyree and Caroline, is the fact that it seems like with all of us who are either single in a relationship or married, that we all struggle with right now is how to be less selfish and more selfless, and starting with ourselves, how to be more selfless with ourselves, because we're always trying to be selfless with everybody around us, our community of church, community of family, community of influencers, or those that we are trying to learn from. And one thing that I've learned is that things can't be forced. Things can't be forced. While we're trying to get through day by day, like, love can't be forced. People cannot be forced to even look at you or find any desire to know you, and especially when you're not being your authentic self. And so, and then going into 2 weeks now of the end of last month and beginning of this next September, like, September is going to be this weekend, Labor Day and everything. That is one thing I want to master, is how to see and pay attention where my energy is going, so that I can conserve my energy for things that really do matter and need my attention, and then just be ready for whatever blessing is to come. And so I want to end with a scripture. So I have this journal that I've had since, I believe, 2018, but I might be wrong. Nope, December 16, 2018, and I have not finished it. When I was younger, I would, like, always write in my journal, and I would be, like, super, super dramatic, because it would always be stuff, like, about my brothers going through my journal, or just family life stuff. So I'm going to end with the scripture, and I hope it helps us. I just opened it up, and it's like a random scripture, and it's in the Doctor in Covenants, and it says, if you have desires to serve God, you are called to the work. I love that scripture, because all of us want to find our purpose in life. All of us want to make an impact on people. At least I would assume so. In some, like, degree, like, something. And if you don't feel like being an impact or whatever, that's on you. But I love that scripture, because it proves that nothing happens unless we work. And that's just cool. That is so familiar and common. Like, nothing works unless you work. I want to say Eric Thomas was the one I learned that from, but I'm probably way off. So I hope in whatever you are aspiring to be and wanting to conquer, that you know it takes work. And not just any kind of work, not even just hard work, but smart work, the most efficient way to work things. And so, I love you guys. Sorry I look like I'm gonna pass out, but I couldn't pass up the opportunity to come and express my love to acquire divine heritage, and also to give you gems of what I learned from our sister Sela and the passing of her from this life into the next. And hopefully all of us can take some time this Wednesday, which is today, or in like 15, 20 minutes, and understand that it's okay to be tired, but it's not okay to stay tired, and that smart work is the best work ethic to have, and to ask for help when things get tough and things get heavy. Okay, love you guys, and we will talk to you tomorrow.